nugo kenshi duchumura tukubabaza bikabije utinda kurakara ntabwo uhita utwitura uduhane uduce iwowe mubyeyi w'ukuri utananirwa abe ngo ajugunye udukuruza ineza yawe ukatwiyegerezanya urukundo rw'iteka urukundo nkunda Jehova Shalom ntacyo narukereranya Jehova Rafa usumba ukwezi n'izuba Jehova Elohim usumbya uburemere byose Jehova Shammah urukundo nkunda Jehova Shalom ntacyo narukereranya Jehova Rafa usumba ukwezi n'izuba Jehova Elohim usumbya uburemere byose Jehova Shammah
hosted the virtual village time, and aren't you excited?
Was to show you guys that we are still a family despite of challenges we're meeting. Please stay safe. Love you so much. And till next time, to the next village time. Stay tuned. Thank you.
Wow, this is amazing moment to see my brothers and sisters sharing their talents in the village amphitheater. I really miss the Friday night of village time. Good evening to everyone. For those who don't know me, my name is Louis and I am a graduate of ASYV class of 2016. I remained close to the ASYV family and now I am doing my international bachelor degree in hotel and tourism management at Vatel. And I am working on my fashion business. This moment, it is a big pleasure to welcome you to the virtual village time. We are so happy to be together tonight to celebrate the village's resilience and to honor someone who means so much to us. Lolly Franz, you mean the hope to us. You taught us to dream big, and we are really proud of you for your hard work and the commitment and the love and the caring personality to the village. Thank you so much. Please enjoy the program and we are so excited to connect with you. And now allow me to welcome our managing director, Shirley Sandra. Thank you so much.
Good evening. Thank you, Louis. It's wonderful to see you. My name is Shirley Sandler and I'm the managing director of the Agahozo-Shalom Youth Village. Thank you for coming together on behalf of ASYV in this exceptional time. Much has changed since last year's village time, and we've faced many challenges, individually and collectively. We're glad you've joined us here tonight to celebrate the resilience of the village, to honor our dear Lori Toll-Franz for her 6 years of service as board chair, and to enjoy our kids' village time performances, their expression of love for the village and the family they have gained through ASYV. Some of you are new to ASYV. Welcome. Some of you have attended Village Time for years. It's good to have you with us tonight. I'd like to offer a special thanks to all of our sponsors who will be highlighted throughout the evening and recognize our Urumuli, Mbutu, Indatwa, and Ngenzi level sponsors here. In the months leading up to tonight, we have raised over $622,000 through this event. Thank you to everyone who has given. Your compassion is making a profound difference for our students. Through our appeal later this evening, which you can contribute to by texting ASYV20 to 833-832-4541, which I'm going to ask Jill to put in the chat box, we hope to raise an additional $125,000 by the end of tonight. We'll talk more about that later. Achieving this goal will allow us to empower hundreds of vulnerable youth, providing a stable home and a loving environment for children who may never have had that before. A high school education focused on preparing every student for career and educational opportunities, health and wellness care that heals physical and mental trauma, and extracurricular enrichment that helps our students dream of a brighter future. This year, your support has also ensured that our students and their families have remained safe with access to food, medical care, and housing throughout the pandemic. We have a few of our alumni here with us tonight, remarkable young people who are well on the way to achieving that dream of a brighter future. I hope you had a chance to speak with them at tables in the lounge earlier. If you didn't, I encourage you to stick around when the event is over, as we will keep the lounge open for post-event cocktails. If you have any questions during the program, use the chat feature and someone will help you out. Now, I'd like to introduce the students of ASYV, sharing their village and why its community and its lessons have meant so much to them this year.
When the pandemic began, I was so scared and I thought maybe no one is going to make it to be alive even today.
We were all used to the village life and we were preparing ourselves for the exams, so we were not really prepared to go back home.
I expected that it would not last for long. I thought that we'll go back at school and continue our studies, but it wasn't true.
The first few months home was boring and scaring, of course.
Due to the pandemic, the coronavirus, many people lost their jobs. The pandemic really caused a lot of changes in different ways, and these effects are still affecting us in a way or in one way or another.
Very unexpected that they will send us some funds, and it was very helpful.
Well, we used it by paying our health insurance and our basic needs.
Things were not very easy, so the funds we received from ASYV were really, really helpful to me and my family.
I managed to talk to our educators through phone calls and also like WhatsApp groups.
My lovely teacher Fiona started a group on WhatsApp and taught us how to cook, and this was very helpful. It really enriched us during the time of the lockdown because we learned a lot regardless of where we were or how the situation was.
I attended a virtual workshop, which is Future Agriculture Leaders, which was prepared by Nebraska University. To the end of it, we had to give our business project. It was a competition. My business project got a reward to the first prize.
We have got a new baby born in our family. In the village, I have learned 7 core values and I have put them in action.
So I do literature in my school studies, and the skills or the studies I get from literature really helped me develop my writing skills. In the middle of the lockdown, I got this opportunity to be a brand ambassador of a culture tour operator, and these writing skills really helped me during the lockdown, where the world got to know about my country and my country's culture through the skills that I got from the village.
I hope that everyone in the village will come back healthy, and I hope that we'll continue our studies as usual and do something that we miss, like performing.
When I am in the village, I get true happiness. My hopes when the village reopens is to see everyone safe and again to see everything like village time, family time, so as a family to meet again.
Good evening from Kigali, Rwanda. My name is Jean-Claude Nkurikiyimfura, and I am the proud director of the Agahozo-Shalom Youth Village. I am thrilled to be here with members of the ASYV family, near and far. In the more than 9 years I have been with ASYV, our kids have inspired me in their response to personal trauma and loss. They have inspired me in how they love and care for each other. I am humbled to work with kids whose response to adversity during the COVID-19 pandemic has been to look out for each other, to trust in the love and support of this family, and above all, to show resilience. As many of you know personally, in 2014, our founder, my mentor and friend, Ann Heyman, passed away suddenly. We were devastated, and I continue to mourn the loss of this remarkable and loving woman. During those dark days, Lori Tall friends bravely stepped forward to serve as ASYV's second chair of the board. Her leadership brought us together. Her kindness and wise words helped us navigate a period without answers. Her love for the kids of ASYV showed us that we could still be the family Anne wanted us to be for these children. That we had within us the capacity to ensure that the village would survive. Many of you here tonight were part of that, which we will never forget. We thank you for that. 6 years ago, during the third class's graduation, Lori gave closing remarks that deeply touched my heart. It was her first graduation speech after Anne's passing. Lori, your words enabled us to find our North Star and to redefine our sense of purpose. You said, and I quote, "Agahozo-Shalom is a place where anything is possible if you work hard enough. We value ideas that are born from curiosity, but it is the passion in each of you which moves these ideas forward." End of quote. Lori, my gratitude to you is immeasurable. You have allowed me to be a thought partner. You have listened to many of my crazy ideas. Above all, you have entrusted me with the leadership of this amazing village during our most difficult hour. Thank you for being my most trusted advisor and confidant. Lori, a few others wanted us to let you know how much you really meant to us. So in order to show what Lori's impact has been, I turn to those who truly know best. Before we hear from our honoree, please enjoy the surprise message to Lori from the students and alumni of ASYV. I thank you and I love you.
Leadership is stepping forward in the face of a challenge and saying, "I can do that. I can help. Or let me show you. You just need to try." In this moment, you get to decide how you are going to work on your dreams and your future. Who do you want to be?
I think, you know, it's important for women to try new things. So, you know, sometimes it's hard to find that thing. I think being brave and trying stuff that you're not comfortable with.
ASYV. You're important to me, and you're important to so many people, and every single one of you is special. You really are, and I have so much hope as I move forward, and I hope you have hope too.
Little friend, you've been a perfect figure of service above self. A million thank yous will never be enough for giving us a home far away from home. We will definitely pay it forward.
It has been a really long journey and yet so short. We really liked having you around and We are so thankful for everything you did for us. It inspired us to see you watching up on us. Thank you.
Thank you, Lori, for being part of the ASYV family and making an amazing chairperson. We will miss you.
Dear Lori, the word thank you would be very less to express our feelings right now. Allow us to show you our gratitude and tell you that we are so grateful for everything. You showed us leadership traits that will not only help us pay it forward, but also change the world. Thank you, we love you so much.
Hey Lori, hope you're doing well. Just want to take this time to thank you for what you've done. When Anne died, you really stepped up and you filled the gap. Things were a little bit tough, but you were there for us. Thanks a lot for what you've done and hope to see you soon.
Hi Lori, thank you very much for your service as the chairperson of the board. We had to see you leave, but your service has left such an excellent mark on our lives, and we wish you the very, very best in your next chapter, and we love you so much.
Life is constant motion, ever changing. Nothing stays the same, even when we don't want life to change. The good news about life and change is it doesn't mean you have to lose anything. Staying part of the ASYV community will help all of us move forward as best we can together. There's so much love here. All of us will continue to grow if we measure the love that we give and we receive. And I thank you.
Lori, on behalf of the Agahozo-Shalom Youth Village, it's our privilege to present you with the Anne Heyman Spirit Award.
Thank you, Sherry. I think I just need a moment to get my thoughts together. That was incredibly beautiful, and I am grateful. Really, really beautiful. Hi, everyone. So from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank all of you for joining Virtual Village Time today and for your support of ASYV. Our co-chairs are the best. What a wonderful turnout. I want to assure you, if you are here today on this call, I know who you are. There is a list, and I am truly blown away. I am honored and humbled to accept the Anne Heyman Spirit Award. It's more meaningful to me than I can put into words. The spirit of Anne will always be in me because she showed me how. Working with Anne prepared me for the biggest challenge of my life, becoming the board chair after her passing. It was the hardest thing I've ever had to tackle, and yet such an honor. And within days, I was in Rwanda for the hardest and most emotional memorial I had ever experienced. I was terrified, grieving, and feeling woefully inadequate and insecure. But if Anne taught me nothing else, it was that anyone can change the world if they have a really good team, even when the odds of success are not very high. Surrounded by kids, educators, staff, donors, family mamas, and all kinds of partners and supporters that week, it became clear we would be okay. There was just too much love and determination for it not to be so. I've been incredibly blessed by the team Anne put in place all those years ago. I can't accept any award without sharing it with those who are on the front lines of some very daunting challenges. The ASYV Board of Directors is one of the greatest teams I have ever worked with. Each of you was so committed to our kids and the work, and I am grateful for all you have taught me. Our Rwanda staff never gave up. You love our mission and our kids, and you inspire me. Our New York staff, now working remotely, have always given above and beyond. Led by Sherry Sandler, who works tirelessly to make sure we have the resources we need for our village and teaches us all why this work is so important. You have been a wonderful steward and friend. And it goes without saying, our ASYV kids are the best team of all. I am beyond proud of you. And there's this guy, some of you may know him. His name is Jean-Claude, or JC. And it's to him that I tip my hat. I would not be here without your partnership and extraordinary dedication, my friend. You empowered me. You never made me feel like any less of a leader than the woman I succeeded. And you've treated me as a true partner. And sometimes you even took my advice. This award belongs to you as well. I am grateful to all my friends and colleagues who've been so supportive over the years. And a special thanks to my parents and siblings who have always encouraged this work my kids, Nick, Joe, and Sam, who never complained when I was away, and my husband, Jeff, who always held down the fort. I love you all, and I am grateful. Everyone here today is part of the team that makes ASYV successful. Our network, our ASYV family, has always been there. You are resilient, too. I hope you will continue to support the village today, as you have always done. In these challenging times, we need you all more than ever. Anne's core values was live on in our kids, and they will live on in me as well, that I can promise you. Thank you for this award and for all that you do for the village. Next year in New York, wishing everyone love, good health, and peace.
Lori, congratulations again. I'm sorry to have surprised you with the video. Please don't yell at me when we're off air meet, but I couldn't resist them. I'm so grateful to be a part of the village with you. It's now my pleasure to introduce Marisa Amiga Isabel, known as Amiga, to share her story with you from Rwanda.
Hi everyone, my name is Marisa Amiga Isabel and I'm a family member and a student of ASYV. Life before ASYV wasn't the easiest. Me and my brother were raised by a single mom in Kigali. She alone had to give us school fees, give us something to eat, give us clothes to wear. Because my brother was the oldest, his school fees always came first. And I was chased out of class many times because my mom hasn't paid my school fees. I got lucky in 2017. I was one of the 128 students admitted in ASYV. Being in ASYV is a blessing. When you reach there, I don't know what happens, but something turns in your life. I was very excited. The houses looked pretty from afar. Everything felt good until at family time in the night when everyone has gone and it was just me and my new family. No one was talking except our mother. We were all nervous. I didn't know that someone you didn't meet, you can connect just like that. And that's when the change began. And it's funny to see how the tables have turned. We laugh, we grow together. And my mom knows me too much, like she knows me too well. I feel like she's my real mom, as in a biological mom. She looks at me with love in her eyes, the love that a mother has for a child. And she really pushes me. She pushes me so bad that I know and I see that she wants me to be something big. Throughout this lockdown of COVID-19, I have often felt powerless and empty. To cope with that, I have been reading books and writing poems about love. I'm grateful to be part of the ASYV family. It has helped me a lot. I have talked to my mom and my teachers. They've showed me that we're in this together and I need to go to the village when I'm safe and I'm ready to learn. And I can be there for my family and take advantage of every opportunity that ASYV has to offer. ASYV has taught me that there is light in the future, and that is what is getting me through this pandemic. I'm filled with joy at the thought of getting back to the village. I'm really excited. I want to study hard and start applying for scholarships. My dream is to become a therapist. I really like listening to people, and I know I can relate to their stories. I know that I can walk through the pain and we can get out of it stronger. I want to take this time to appreciate everyone who contributes to our growth, who contributes to mending our hearts. It really means a lot, a lot, a lot.
You've seen tonight how the resilience of kids like Amiga lives on during this difficult time, and how ASYV has helped her and our other kids transform their lives. You've seen the pride and the joy they take in their village family. You've seen the incredible legacy Lori has nurtured and the kind of love and dedication it takes to build a legacy like that. Tonight, I ask you to honor that legacy by helping us provide the transformative experience our students need to thrive. Our goal this evening is to raise an additional $125,000. Help us ensure that regardless of this challenging year, more than 500 orphaned and vulnerable youth will face the world with a family behind them, with this family behind them. After the appeal, make sure you stick around for our final Village Time performance. Now, here's how this will work. You can text a pledge directly on your phone by texting ASYV20 to 833-832-4541. As so many of you have already done, this is incredible. Okay, you will receive a text back that will prompt you to enter the amount of your gift, and then you can confirm your gift with the word yes. It's going to ask you to enter your name, as you can see, but you can also remain anonymous. Now, I know you guys, so I'm telling you, whatever name you put is going to end up on that screen for everyone to see. Don't embarrass me by making me read it aloud, okay? You'll be texted a link to a secure online form so you can pay online. If you want to make a pledge through the system so that we can count it up here tonight towards our goal, but pay by another method, text the amount and one of the ASYV staff will reach out to you in the coming days to process your gift through your donor advised fund, by wire, or by check. We're already started, so let's go. If you have a problem, put it in the chat and Jill will help you out. This is incredible. So I want to call out a couple of donors to say thank you. This is wonderful. Brian and Cheryl and Jillian, the Blitzer family, the Hoover family. I know this gift that says Jill Elias is actually from Moshe Bronstein. Moshe and your family, thank you so much. This $5,000 that says from Julia, we're having some tech stuff going on behind the scenes here. That's from Liz Stern. Thank you so much. $1,200, not from Matt, but actually Michelle Barrick. You guys are incredible. Oh my goodness, it's going up. Okay, the Shiri fan club. I feel like now I have to read that. $180. This is amazing. We're already at $24,000. I want to tell you a little bit about what this money does. $25,000, which we're about to hit, will enable us to provide safe, secure, and loving housing for more than half our kids for 1 year. That's over 250 kids. $10,000 will provide medical and psychosocial care for 200 kids in 1 year. I'm going to stop and do some thank yous. Look at us. The number is going up. The Schwartzman family, Mercedes, Rachel Sherman, Seth Marin with $50,000. We just surpassed $77,000. I actually can't keep up with this number. Matt Kuttner, this is wonderful. A couple of anonymous gifts. See, you can put in whatever name you want. Anonymous is fine. You guys are incredible. My Aunt Mary just gave. Every gift, every amount helps us, moves us towards our goal, and helps us make sure we can offer this incredible, meaningful program to our kids in a difficult year like this one, in a regular year like the years we hope are coming. You guys are doing an amazing job. Larry with $500, Jamie with $25, thank you. Like I said, every gift matters as we move towards our goal of $125,000 tonight. I want to thank Kim and Neil Franz. I want to thank, yes, I promised you, right? I would read the names out, and here I go doing it. All right, let me tell you a little bit more about what you guys can make possible this evening. $5,000 funds clean water and hygiene for 100 kids for 1 year. It's particularly important in a year like this one, where hand washing is going to be the thing that saves lives, right? We know that in our own lives. We certainly know that in the village, that we have to help our kids maintain hygiene to keep each other and to keep our community safe. We're above $83,000 now. This is fantastic. I want to thank Hillary and Taylor Landy. I want to thank the Carrie John Walker Fund for all of these incredible gifts. And from Nadine, another anonymous, another yes. You guys are into that tonight. I'm there for it. We're almost to $85,000. Like I said, bigger gifts, smaller gifts, any gift that is within your means, that feels right to you this evening, is really important to moving us towards our goal. The numbers are just going up and up there. I'm going to call out a couple more names. Elizabeth Heyman, Linda Stocknoff, Julia Lisi. I think that one is actually Julia. Kathy Harris. Kathy, thank you so much. It's a wonderful gift. We are almost at $90,000 right now. I'm going to pause us in our appeal in just a few minutes, but can we break $90,000 before we move on to a little bit more programming? And we'll come back to this part of the night again in a few moments and see where our thermometer has gotten us. All right, let me call out a couple more names. We have Josh Leskowitz, we have Jill and Jimmy, Gail and Elliot, Nancy, all of you. Thank you so much for this impact you are making tonight. I'm going to keep holding Rachel, another anonymous. I think these numbers are just going. I think we're kind of catching up here as we go. Like I said, every gift matters. I want to give you guys a sense of where we are, right? $90,000 is going to put us at raising $710,000 through this event, which is incredible. You know, our original goal for this event was $1 million. And when the pandemic hit, whoa, something big just happened. Trudy and Bob Gottesman, $25,000. Thank you so much. We are at $115,000 now. That's incredible. That puts us at our goal for the evening and almost to our goal for the appeal, which is $125,000. That's my Aunt Shirley O'Hallam right there. It's my Aunt Shirley. Andrea and Fred, we got the lucky sevens. We have Ben. We have a couple more yeses. I like the positivity. You guys are absolutely fantastic. We're at $116,000. I don't want to stop us here. I want the night to be able to keep going, but I think these gifts are going to keep coming in, and I think we can surpass $125,000 tonight. I'm going to do a couple more thank yous, and then I'm going to move us on in this program. Galit and Frank, you guys are wonderful. Dahlia, $10, thank you so much. These are incredible gifts. There are so many people I'm missing. All right, I'm seeing in the chat to keep it going. I'm going to just keep going. I'm going to keep reading names. We are at $120,000. We are in striking distance of our $125,000 goal. This is remarkable. I want to tell you a little bit about the people you're seeing up on this list tonight. You are seeing board members of the village. We hit it. We're at $135,000. This is incredible. Bob and Jane Toll, $10,000. You guys are wonderful. We have committee members, people who give of their time to the village. We have former fellows who spent a year in the village. And I think we have kids taking part tonight, children here in the States, children in Rwanda. We are almost at $140,000. Roberta Bass, thank you. Lori rocks as she does. I agree. This is incredible. Dr. Joel, the Barthel family, Patty, you guys, this is absolutely remarkable. We have surpassed $140,000. I'm going to get off the screen, but I want you all to keep going. I mean, of course I do. But I know we have a couple important things still coming up, and I promise you, I will check back in with that thermometer and let you know where we are in just a little bit. And so now, while our text to pledge remains open, if you haven't yet given and you want to, please do. We will check back in. It is my absolute pleasure to introduce our chair of the board, Liz Stern.
Hello, I'm Liz, and I'm honored and humbled to be following in Lori and Anne's footsteps, and to be able to represent our amazing ASYV board of directors this evening. Thank you, Sherry, for the passionate virtual appeal. It's incredible. And for your outstanding work on behalf of ASYV. Thank you to all of you too for joining us to connect with our kids and the extended ASYV family, and for your support of our mission. It's wonderful to be able to welcome people from across the country and the world for this unique event. You know, somehow the distance doesn't seem so great when we get to virtually sit around a table and chat with friends, new and old. I would especially like to thank our sponsors at the Ishema, Imena, and Isanga levels for their generous and sustaining contributions. Back in March, as you know, when the village abruptly shut down by the government mandate, along with all the other schools in Rwanda, there was so much uncertainty and fear. The most critical questions for us: would our students be okay away from the village, and when could we welcome them back? We have a responsibility to our kids, and that responsibility did not pause just because they were outside our walls. With your help, we made sure that they got the resources they needed during the shutdown in Rwanda, and we worked diligently to prepare our program and facility for their return. And so now I look forward to the village safely reopening next week, beginning next week, to our students with comprehensive testing, protective gear, 60 new hand washing stations, and distancing protocols in place. Thank you for standing with us in the face of this new and extraordinary challenge. The board is immensely proud of our students, our staff, and the entire village team who have demonstrated great resilience in the face of adversity. Tonight, through Amiga's story, the kids' reflections on Lori's leadership, and the joy they showed performing back in the village, I think you've seen that while resilience can be innate, it can also be cultivated. It can flourish when brave young people have a safe place to call home and the opportunity to learn, and a community that will help them respond to the world's challenges. For the final performance of this special evening, I welcome our alumni and their cover of Lean on Me. Thank you.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there is always tomorrow.
Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride. If I have things you need to borrow for, no one can feel those of your needs that you won't let choke.
You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'll understand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
If there is a Lord, you have to be that you can't carry. I'm right down the road, I'll share your load if you just call me.
You gotta lean on me when you're not strong, 'cause I'll be your friend and I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. It won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Well, our kids know how to say something about coming together across the distance, don't they? Thank you again for joining us this evening to honor Lori and celebrate our students. I hope you've enjoyed hearing their gorgeous words and voices tonight, and that you, like I did, felt close to the village. I want to check back on that thermometer, as I promised you. Can you guys pull that up for me? Oh my, I have no words. This is incredible. We are at $217,000. It's going to take me a second to even do the math there. That puts us, no really, it's going to take me a second to do the math there. That puts us at 837,000 for tonight, which is, I'm pulling it together. That's incredible. Thank you all so much for this remarkable gift. I'll call out a couple more names just from what I can see. Judy Brown, my mom, Eliane Sandler, Sam Elias, Castle Financial, Ron and Judy, Christy, that's incredible, thank you. What I take to be the Lori Franz fan club, Seth Rosenzweig, Oliver and Liliana, Toddler Robin, Jane and Bob Toll, thank you again, that's incredible. Anna and Sam, we love you guys. Rob and Natasha, yes. And Rob Leibel, there are more. The Hoover family, this is just remarkable. ASYV family, you are absolutely incredible tonight. I can't tell you what you've made possible for us and the kind of security and love we will feel this year. In this very, very difficult year, you all have been absolutely remarkable. And we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. On that note, I want to send you back in just a second to the lounge where you can talk to Lori, talk to each other, talk to the kids. I'll be there, and we can give our thanks in person to all of you. So when this ends in just a second, The program will force you back into the lounge. You can go back to the tables you were at or join other tables. If you haven't had a chance to talk to the alumni, I encourage you to do so. A bunch of them have spoken in the chat tonight. A bunch of them performed in our videos, and I know we'd love to thank them in person. So thank you again for coming to our first ever virtual Village Time.